Happy Monday, Mighty Mustangs. This week's motivational quote is, "For there is always light if we're only brave enough to see it. If we're only brave enough to be it," by Amanda Gortman. This quote means that even when it seems dark, we can look for light. The light means good things in life. We can be that light and spread kindness to others.
This Friday at Maidu, we will be continuing our school spirit count. Don't forget to wear your school colors. I wonder who will get the school trophies this week. Next week, there is no school for President's Week. There is no school starting Monday, February 15th through Friday, February 19th. Have a great week, Mustangs.
Today, we are going to watch Mrs. Hageman's class to see how she does on pickup. Let's remember that when we go out to pickup, we are walking in our line all the way out, socially distanced. Let's remember if we are walkers and our parents are picking us up, we walk down to Mrs. Berg and we wait there with Mrs. Berg and we walk out at one time and we don't run. We're waiting to see our parent and let Mrs. Berg know that our parent's there for our safety. And then if you are a bus rider, remember you are lining up socially distanced and Miss Archuleta's gonna come get you. So let's see how Miss Hageman's class does. If you think they did a great job at the end, I want you to give them a big old thumbs up, all right? All right, let's see how they're doing.
You close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all? And if you close your eyes, does it almost feel like you've been here before? Oh, how I'm beginning to be an optimist about this. How I'm beginning to be an optimist about this. If you close your eyes, does it almost feel like nothing changed at all?
Good morning, it's Miss Krisiak. Today we are going to review a few of the tools that we've learned in the last few weeks. The first tool we talked about was the breathing tool. Remember, it's the measuring tape. The measuring tape says, "I will calm myself and check in." Taking several deep breaths when we are feeling anxious, nervous, angry, or sad helps our body feel better again. Next, we learned about the garbage can tool. And the garbage can tool, remember? We use the garbage can tool when we are putting little problems in the garbage can and letting them go. So if someone calls you a name or someone accidentally bumps into you, you're going to put those right in the garbage can and let it go. We also learned about the patience tool. Patience tool is right here, and that is, I am strong enough to wait. The patience tool allows us to think about things that excite us or things that we're looking forward to help us pass the time and allow us to be patient while we're waiting. The tool we discussed last week, does anybody remember what it was? That's right. It was the apology and forgiveness tool. Remember, we're gluing two pieces of paper together, just like friendships. This tool reminds us that we need to apologize when we've hurt someone's feelings or when we didn't make the best choice in a situation. This tool reminds us that we also need to forgive our friends when they say, "I'm sorry." Let's go check in with some Mighty students to see what their favorite tool is.
Chloe, what's your favorite toolbox tool?
My favorite toolbox tool is the trash can, because I can use it when my neighbors are not being nice to me.
How's that help you?
It makes them stop so we can get back to playing happily again.
What is your favorite toolbox tool and when do you use it?
I like the garbage can tool because I always use it helping with my brother and sister, because I can just throw away the little things they do and I can go on with my day.
All right, and what tool do you love?
I love the patience tool because I have a lot of patience for my brothers.
Okay, and can you show me how you use that? All right, and then can you show me how you use your garbage can tool? All right, great job, guys. Okay, Margaret, what toolbox tool do you like to use and when do you use it?
I like using the breathing tool and I use it when I'm mad.
Welcome to Marty's Joke of the Week.
How do you make a tissue dance?
I don't know, how?
You put a little boogie in it.